Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to build a cheap external SSD drive for your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So if you want an external drive for your Mac, you may look and find that there are a lot of different choices. Most of those are spinning hard drives or tiny little flash drives like these. Now these little flash drives are great for storage, but they're not very fast and they don't really work well when you're using them a lot. So if you're editing photos or videos or things that are stored on these flash drives, it's going to be tough going. And spinning hard drives are great for things like backups where speed isn't that important. But you may think, well, isn't the perfect solution an SSD drive? A solid state drive is just like the drive that comes in modern Macs. It's fast and they're small and light. So you'd think that there'd be a ton of them out there. But there aren't really that many, and the ones that are out there are pretty expensive. But you could build one yourself pretty cheaply. So you need two things to make one on your own. First, you need the SSD itself, which looks like a little memory stick. It's not memory, it's storage, but they're both chips on a little stick, so they look similar. Here is one I chose. There are so many different ones like it, but this one was pretty inexpensive. It's a 256 gig SSD. Cost $38. It's not the fastest one out there, but it was a good one for me to play around with. So you get one of these, but there's no way to connect it to your Mac. You need an enclosure, in other words, a box for this to go in. For that, I chose this one. Again, it's a pretty cheap model. Not the best one out there, but a good price for one to play around with. Now, the important thing is to match the enclosure to the drive. So if we look at the drive itself, we can see a few things about it. One is that it is NVMe M.2. And if we look here, we can see it's the type of M.2 is actually 2280. Now, if I go over to this enclosure here, I could see that this is for NVMe SSD drives. So far, so good. And it's M.2 and it supports 2280. So whichever one you choose, you want to make sure that they are compatible between these two. So here's what each one looks like outside of the box. So you can see the enclosure is basically the internal part and then the casing around it. And then all I need to do is to basically take the SSD drive, insert it in. Each enclosure is going to work a little differently, so you have to follow the instructions carefully. This one you insert in and then you screw down the other end so it's firmly in place. It also comes with this thermal insulator. It's just a special little stick-on insulator here and you just put it on top. Drives get hot. In your Mac there's ventilation, sometimes fans, that cool down all the parts. In this little enclosure there's no cooling system, but this will help take some of the heat off of it. This is one of the problems that these flash drives have. They get really hot and they fail to work really well if you're using them intensively. And then I put the enclosure around it and I screw that in place. Now this enclosure has a USB-C shaped port at one end and it comes with two cables. One goes USB-C to USB-C, which is perfect for plugging into all the latest Macs and the MacBooks that have been around for years. It also comes with an older style USB connector so I can still plug it into my older MacBook Pro. A lot of these enclosures will only come with one or the other, so make sure you get the one that will fit with your Mac. So once I have this all assembled, it's just a matter of connecting it to your Mac, bringing up disk utility and formatting the drive. In most cases you're going to want to format it Apple Pro File System APFS for use as an external drive with any Mac using Mojave, Catalina, or beyond. If you've got a Mac that's before Mojave, you're probably going to want to format it as HFS. And also if you're going to be using this for Time Machine, but I wouldn't use an SSD for Time Machine. Time Machine really doesn't require fast read and write speeds. It's a backup. It's not something you're actually working with to edit files and things. So it's kind of a waste of money to get an SSD. You can just get a regular spinning hard drive for that, because then you can go way up in size to a 4 or 8 or even 12 terabyte drive to have a lot of storage space for backups. Now let's talk about speeds here for a minute. You have several different measurements of speed. You've got the speed of the SSD, you've got the speed of the connection, and you've got the speed of the enclosure. If you're using USB 3.1 on modern Macs, that's 10 gigabits per second. The enclosure, the one I'm showing here, the specifications say that is also 10 gigabits per second. And the SSD drive, that one shows as 2100 megabytes per second. There's a lot of confusion here because there's gigabytes per second, gigabits per second, megabytes per second, and megabits per second. All those are valid measurements of speed. More or less, going from mega to giga is a jump of 1,000 times. So 1,000 megabytes would be 1 gigabyte. And bits to bytes, there are 8 bits in a byte. So a measurement of 2,100 megabytes per second, you would take that and multiply by 8 to go from bytes to bits. And then you would divide by 1,000 to go from mega to giga. So that's about 16.8 gigabits per second. So the actual speed of the drive should be the slowest of these, which would be 10 gigabits per second. When I actually tested it, it was actually a little bit slower than that, coming in at around 7 gigabits per second. Now compare that to an internal drive. Macs use internal drives that are usually pretty fast. So as a comparison, I looked at the internal SSD on my 2016 MacBook Pro, and that was getting me over 18 gigabits per second. So the external drive was about half the speed of my internal drive. You can, of course, look for an SSD that's a little faster, pay a little bit more, and you can go better than the 2100 megabytes per second that this particular cheap model had. So you could maybe get a little bit closer to your internal drive speeds. But it's always going to be better to run applications, boot the system, and work with files on your internal SSD than an external one. At least that's true for USB. If you're using Thunderbolt with a fast enough enclosure and a fast enough SSD, then you should be able to get the same speed from an external drive. But it's going to cost a lot more to do that all with Thunderbolt than with USB 3.1. But the result that I got with this is for less than $70, I have a 256 gig external drive. It's fast enough for me to work with files like photos and videos from. It's even fast enough for me to boot from, although I wouldn't want to boot from this drive and actually work with it on a day-to-day basis. I'd want to use the internal drive for that. So I hope you found this useful as to how easy it is to build a cheap external SSD drive for your Mac. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.